The Truth of Mary Magdalene's Journey
by Mary Magdalene and Natalie Glasson, August 5, 2016, Sacred School of Omna.
Natalie.
Recently I had the opportunity to visit the Grot de la Sainte-Baume, which is a cave in the south of France, where it is said that Mary Magdalene spent much of her time after the crucifixion, resurrection and ascension of Jesus. The cave is on the side of a mountain, and it takes about a 45-minute steep walk through glorious and luscious woodland to reach this sacred place. Before entering the cave, I began to communicate with Mary Magdalene to discover the purpose of my visit and why I was being guided to visit the grotto. Below is what I received, information that Mary Magdalene wanted to share not just with me, with everyone.
Mary Magdalene.
It is an honor to connect with you, and I shower you in the vibrations of the divine goddess and goddess Isis. Even as a child I wore the symbol of the golden serpent, a symbol of being initiated into the teachings of the divine feminine and goddess Isis. I was and remain a high priestess of goddess Isis, dedicated to the power, magic, and love of the purest form of the sacred goddess. It was my training which paved my way to my union with Jesus, as well as preparing me to continue the teachings shared with both of us after his ascension. The teachings Jesus shared were born from love and given in love. They represented the union of the masculine and feminine vibrations of the Creator in harmony and oneness, awakening the same within all. During the times when Jesus shared his teachings, I would also receive the same downloads of energy and inspiration. As a representative of the divine feminine, I acted as an anchor, grounding the sacred energy into the earth and consciousness of humanity. It was after the ascension of Jesus that I was guided to continue to share the detailed teachings and healing practices I had received with others. One of my greatest purposes at that time was to share my wisdom with those devoted to the goddess, as they would retain the purity of the teachings while preserving them for generations to come. The divine directions and tasks given to me by the Creator seemed endless at that time. I was to develop the presence of the goddess in many people so this energy may continue to nurture the world and the teachings of Jesus, as well as healing some devastation which occurred in humanity due to misunderstanding when Jesus left the earth. I was to distribute energetic codes, templates and healing, as well as physical scrolls, objects, tools and crystals of spiritual value in certain sacred places. My purpose was to support the preservation and continuation of the healing and awakening Jesus had begun. I had another very beautiful role, a role which every day healed my heartbreak of physically losing Jesus, even though I understood the truth of the matter. This role encouraged me to be determined to achieve the tasks given to me by the Divine Creator, while also filling my days with fun, love, and laughter. In my opinion, it is the most sacred role of a woman. I was given the gift of being a mother. Sar was the creation of the Divine Creator to embody my energies as Mary Magdalene and Jesus' sacred vibrations. She really was the image of the union of us both in more ways than seemed possible. A sacred gift to the earth and me. She carried many names, the Golden Chalice, the Golden Serpent and the Union of the Divine in Manifestation, to name a few. Our destination, Sar and I, along with a few sisters of the light, was France. Our purpose when arriving in the south of France was to begin the process of distributing the many sacred energetic and physical scrolls, tools and templates which had been placed in our possession. These were to be given to specific people and hidden in certain places to preserve their safety. We were greeted and supported by the members of a goddess Isis temple dedicated to the divine feminine. These women of such profound inner beauty supported our mission and later led us to a space of sanctuary near their temple. Our sanctuary was a cave in the south of France known now as the Grotte de la Sainte-Baume. Sar was 3 years old when we arrived at our new home, which was a hiding place for us and a space where I could continue to teach.
Natalie.
During my time in the cave, the presence of Mary Magdalene was very strong, even though this area, like a church, now has been overseen for many years by monks. The divine feminine vibrations still remained within its energy. As Mary Magdalene appeared in my third eye before me, it was Sar whom she pushed forth to me. Sar seemed to me to be about 12 years old when Mary Magdalene was bringing her into my awareness. Mary Magdalene wanted Sar to share some of her insights into her life in the cave. I had never consciously met Sar before, so it was a new experience for me. Sar shared some visions with me. The first being a procession of women dressed in white wearing the mark of the golden serpent walking up through the woodland to the cave. Sar told me that they came to visit them in the cave every day, bringing food and anything they'd needed. She said she enjoyed their visits as some of the initiates of the goddess Isis temple were of similar age to her, or even younger, so she had time to talk and play with them before the daily ceremony led by Mary Magdalene. She told me how she loved running through the woodland with her friends. Like her, they did not really know what the outside world was like, however, they enjoyed sharing stories of their inner plane experiences. Sar shared that she also enjoyed the daily ceremony held within the cave as it allowed her to see her mother at work, the power, grace and wisdom she exuded. The second vision Sar shared with me was of herself during nighttime embraced in her mother's arms within the cave as her mother shared her memories of Jesus. She would ask her mother to share everything she knew about her father from his birth to his ascension. Sar said she loved these times. The most as sometimes in those intimate moments of sharing with her mother, her father would appear as an energetic form in the cave to share some time with them. Sar told me that she enjoyed living in the cave as she had everything she needed. I believe Mary Magdalene's sharing of Jesus' lifetime with Sar was her way of guiding Sar through her own initiations and preparing her for her adult life.
Mary Magdalene.
After 15 years when Sar was 18 years old, I knew it was time to support Sar in the next stage of her life. I had known from the moment we arrived at the cave that in 15 years' time Sar and I would leave the safety of the cave and travel to a sacred druid community in England. Our destination is now known as Glastonbury. I knew her purpose was to marry and remain with the druid community, so our journey to England was both exciting as I knew a new life awaited Sar while also being heartbreaking, as I knew I would be making the journey back to France without her. It was not long before Sar was in love and married to a soul who was deeply familiar to her, a soul she had journeyed with many lifetimes together. They had many children and a very blissful life. Sar took on the role of sharing the teachings of love passed down to her from her father and myself. Her healing powers were breathtakingly beautiful. Sar spent 50 years in Glastonbury. At the age of 68 she journeyed to Scotland where she lived for the remainder of her life, passing over when she was around 80 years old. I, Mary Magdalene, returned to the south of France and lived out my days within the temple of goddess Isis with the women who had cared for Sar and I for 15 years. I no longer need to live in the cave to protect my daughter and ensure her safety, so I enjoyed my time surrounded by the beautiful souls of the temple. I visited the cave now and then when I felt that Jesus wanted to appear to me and share some time with me. I traveled a little around France. However, I had completed my tasks given to me by the Divine Creator, so I was able to spend much time in peace and solitude, sometimes reliving my memories, other times in deep communion with the Creator. I ascended leaving my body behind when I was around the age of 100. I wanted to share the truth of my journey after the ascension of Jesus so we may connect on a deeper level, and so you may further access the truth of my being and soul. I am Mary Magdalene. Thank you.